Hey everybody, and welcome to another episode 19, I believe, of Let's Build Minecraft. Today I've already started on something here. I kind of want to show you the halfway point and give you some tips on how I come up with different designs for different houses. Just for future reference, this is the area right here that I'm focusing on next. So we put a lot of time into that wheat field right there. Well, I want everything between these houses and that bridge to look complete. Anyways, get my food. All right, this is my next house. Let's get this out of the way. Don't need ya. So I had basically two ideas that I wanted to put into one building. And I think that's a good way to get a variety in your build. So the first one is I want two different roofs, one at one story high and one at two stories high. Two stories being on top of this one. And I also want an entrance to one of them being tucked away, or particularly the bottom one, to be tucked away underneath, sort of like we have this one, except not really a basement. I wanted it to be more of a first floor entrance. So that's how we got this. So it's still coming along here. Now my next challenge in building this is the basic layout, because we've got designs, basically design templates that we throw into every build, like these things on the sides of all the roofs and then hay on top. So we basically have to figure out the shape and from there go with it. So if we go something like that, is that odd numbers? That's even numbers. No, that's odd numbers. I kind of want to take this back. Let's take it back even more. I need to just get rid of all the sunflowers. Maybe I'll make a sunflower field somewhere else, but not here. In my town. I don't want it. All right, so let's just place down our dirt. I think I'm going to have, for the sake of dimension, I'm completely drawing a blank. I want this section of the house to be further back than this one. I think this might be a really short shack, something like, let's get some oak wood, something like that. And then this one further out. So there's the basic shape of our house, right? And then we can just fill this in. Miss that. Fill that in, do our roof, and then that's the basic design for that. Let's knock these out. Never build on top of dirt like that. That's a big no-no to me. It feels like it's getting dark. You can tell when it's going to get dark with these shaders on, because it's like very noticeable sunset. It's kind of blinding, in fact. But anyways, so let's fill in this cobblestone, at least another thing. So you can kind of see where I'm going with this, where we have different reoccurring patterns. We come up with a shape and then we fill in the patterns. And then every now and then I just kind of come up with something new like this. I don't know if there's a name. I'm pretty sure there's a name for it, but I don't know what it is, for this little face inside the roof here. And then I put a little window up there and that does look all the way through. I did the exact same thing on this side. We need to go to sleep. Look how pretty that is. Shining through our, windmill. One of these times when it starts raining, I'll need to show you what it looks like around here with the, that's not a bed. with the Seuss, like, ultra shaders, go to sleep. Because it looks like something else. It's very atmospheric, perhaps too atmospheric. Fall out of bed. Good job, dang guy. Alright, but anyways, this is going to be some off-camera work. What I also want to start today, and maybe get a good amount of progress on, is right here. This is going to be a major part of the docks for the smaller boats that we've talked about that can fit underneath that bridge, larger boats being on the other side of that island right there. So how do we start something like this? I honestly haven't thought too much about it. So let's just kind of square this area out. And first thing that I want is, I can't pick those up. The first thing I want is stairs here. Let's throw in some brick stairs every now and then. Use up the rest of our bricks. Sure. Yeah. Alright, so that's going to be our way down. That's going to be connected to the road that's going to be coming through here. And then maybe I can do this off camera as well. Get some of the stupid cobble out of the way. Just kind of mark where it's going to be. And then we can take this down. I know where it's going to be. So this road's going to lead around here. I think we can fit a house right here. And then port. Going down right here. And I want a wall. A wall. I want a wall similar to what we had all the way over there in the wheat fields. So that's going to be a reoccurring theme. We talked about that. I'm going to gather some resources. I'm going to have a quick mock-up of what I want here. Depth is the word I was thinking of. I'm back here at my rather bleak looking base over by the swamp lake town. Yes, I have a sissy bar on the on the nether portal, so that guy, the much lesser of the two skeleton horses that I have, does not go in there. Although maybe he'd feel much more at home there. I'm enchanting books, I think. Unless something changes. Because I'm trying to get books with something for these to fight the dragon. And we hit level 33. This can give us fire protection. I still don't know if fire protection protects you against the dragon's breath. Hold on, let me look that up. Because if it does, I want it. Okay, so as far as I can tell looking at the wiki, it doesn't actually say it specifically, but it specifies what type of attack that it applies to, and I can only assume that the dragon's like fireball. I think one of them is an explosive, so blast protection can be good, and another is I was just counting out there. Another is fire, I believe. So I want to make boots and a helmet. Well, what do I have on these? I do have fire protection on these. If I could get protection on them, let's make a helmet at least, because we are going to want a diamond helmet. Phone go off. Excuse me. So let's see what we can get on the helmet. Put those away. Protection 4, so I'm going to go for that. Protection 4, Aqua Affinity. Not ideal, but we got the Protection 4. Let's just go ahead and see what we can get on boots. Well, what did I say that we had on these? Fire Protection. Okay, if we can get Protection 4 on those boots, then we'll go for it. The Ender Dragon is approaching faster than I want it to. Fire Protection 4. Okay, so I'm going to put these away. keep them for testing. I'll check back with them every now and then to see if it's something that I want. Power 4, Feather Falling 2. Maybe I'll just go with that instead of that. Because I'd rather have Feather Falling than a useless Power 4. I mean, I already have a Power 5 bow. So, Feather Falling 2. What would that take for us to put those on our boots? 2. Okay. Got a little bit further to go now to get back to where we want to be for more enchanting. I wonder how much it would take to repair that helmet. Gotta take it off, though. 2. Sure. Did that just destroy our anvil? I feel like I have not used that anvil very much. But apparently it just destroyed it. I've never broken an anvil before. They must have reduced the durability on those because that was not very much. Alright, back to work. Before we go, I just want everyone to see how pretty this is. This is coming out of our base in this little homemade swamp. Let's turn up the shaders, why don't we? Turn up to high. We're gonna get pretty bad frame rates here. Yeah, look at that. Take a screenshot of that. Sun is a little bit too intense, but I like this area. And welcome back, everybody. I hope that you liked what I just put together right there. Let me get back down to Earth. Put on some more FPS-friendly shaders. I've been using light. And let's get back to survival. Yeah, that was it. Yeah, I hope that you like what I did right there. Ooh. Yeah, there we go. I've been building quite a bit here. You've probably seen about everything that I've built in that little sequence there. I've yet to edit it and everything. But let's see. We can go to sleep, and then I'll give you a quick rundown of what we actually did. There we go. Perfect timing. And we sleep with our trusty axe. Okay, so first thing I did, this road. It was only going up to about here when we stopped. I extended it. This isn't like a final product. It may be changed, especially things along the road, like that wall right there that I have. This area right here is very subject to change. I want it to be much more natural and inviting. But it comes over here. Once we get into the town, it opens up a little bit more, becomes more stone, more cobble, yada yada. This house right here, more or less done. Okay, its backside still got to be done. Yeah, more or less done, though. Here's what you can get. Oh, no. Talk about that in a minute. I was talking about how I wanted a roof on two different levels on the same house with an entry on two different levels on the same house. Well, we go in here, and ideally we could have some kind of staircase leading up to there, a big first floor here and then a small second floor up there. Let's see, what else did I do? This is just a little wheelbarrow. This used to work a lot better when the boats didn't have the dang paddles on them. But it's okay. I keep bumping into this thing. Whenever I'm going from down here to building over there, I keep trying to cut across, and then I'll hit it, and then it moves. And I gotta lower these things and try to nudge it back into place. But this is our wheelbarrow with paddles. And it's got some hay next to it that I guess that people put some hay into the wheelbarrows, and then they wheelbarrow it off to do who knows what. The dock. I really like this dock here. So I wanted it to look like there was dirt and grime and rocks stuck between the boards, the wood. So we got coarse dirt and gravel mixed in here. We've got dirt, or we've got grass growing through it. Different textures of wood, and then, you know, I did it so that there's more dirt and more, that's actually jungle wood in the more traveled places. So people walk down here, super dirty right here. Walk up to this dock, there's kind of a path leading up to it. Path leading this way and up there. Not so much travel right there. There's a little bit more oak to show it. Same for right there, kind of. I might adjust it a little bit. This dock is not final. It's going to extend over here in some form or fashion. How or why or what function it serves, all that stuff, I'm not completely sure yet. We might have a crane, because right here, this building is half finished. I just started on this, and I'm not going to have it done before the end of the episode, but I was really playing around. I had this idea that we have a building with two stories, accessible from the first story down here, and then when we go up here, it's accessible. See, I gotta be careful of that thing. It's accessible from the second story. So the idea is, this will have to all be terraformed and stuff, but the idea is you come in with your shipment of hay and your wheelbarrow, maybe, and then you put it onto this thing, and this thing is supposed to be like an elevator. It lowers it down, brings it up maybe. Then there will be like a big industrial door right here. Maybe we have a crane right here. The only bad thing about that is the bigger boats that would be carrying more shipment, more cargo, would be over on that side of the island. So we're going to have to maybe think of a way. There's going to be another bridge over here. Maybe it could serve as a way for that to transport over to there, and then a bigger crane over there. Maybe a small crane here. Two cranes could be good, especially if one's smaller and one's bigger. That bigger one would draw a lot more attention. It would be a focal point. The smaller one would be a bit of a focal point too, but it would add different levels of detail, it would add different levels of interest. The bigger one's going to be more interesting. So that's just something to think about. We'll have to see how that turns out. Is there much else? I don't think so. This wall we did, I've been going through a ton of stone. In fact, I'm basically out. I have a lot more at the other base, but I don't like going all the way back there. I did make a trip all the way. Excuse me. Milky burp. I just had some milk. I did go all the way back and filled up my ender chest as full as I could with cobblestone, which was like half full, and it's gone. I've used it, and it's amazing. It doesn't seem like I've used that much. Like, I've been frugal too. These are half slabs. These are half slabs. The cobblestone ones aren't half slabs because they actually have a different texture on top. Actually, I think we can, yeah, right here. I think they do. They used to? I think in the original John Smith they used to. Maybe they don't anymore. Here's the best comparison that we'll have. Right. Let's Let's do it right here. They must have changed them, because I'm fairly certain that at one point they were not the same, and I didn't like it. So I guess if I really wanted to be frugal, I could take all these out, cut my losses in half. But cobblestone, I'm not too worried about. Yeah, this place is... I really like this area right here. This is making me feel like we have a town. Standing right here, we can see a few houses. You know, we're enclosed by all more or less man-made stuff, which is what gives you the feeling of being in a city, being around man-made stuff. So we have this dock, the wall, bridge, houses, industrial building with an elevator thing. Yeah, I really like the way that's pulling together. Not really sure. Next direction that we go, we could fill up these waters with a few of those boats that we put in the other town. We could, you know, we could have a road extend through here and maybe start putting more buildings. I think what I'm going to like to do is make a building on the side, like not the main focal of the episode, but on the side of every episode, kind of like this one. So on each episode, we can make some progress, or maybe even two houses. I'm really interested in starting on that island over there with the port and everything, and make a larger boat. That I have no idea how I'm going to do. We're going to have to get on that, maybe get to some creative mode on my own, on a test world, start building up some designs. But anyway, I have no idea what this video is at. It might be a little short if the editing turned out to be not that long. But last time I said that it was short, it was like 34 minutes. So I don't have a clue. So if we're at 34 minutes right now, then whoopsies. But anyways, let's get down to our beautiful little wheat field without trampling. Nope. I really like these shaders now. But we don't need any more beautiful shots, because you just had a whole montage of beautiful shots. I just kind of wanted to show off the area in our new shaders that we can get. But anyways, if you like this video, then leave a like and subscribe. Thank you. Goodbye. What I do, da da do, da da do.